Now here you can see power rating of common electrical appliances. Generally, whenever you take any electrical appliance, suppose there's a bulb, okay, that bulb has two ratings in it. One, it indicates about the power, and one rating indicates the voltage. At which voltage the bulb will consume this much power. Okay, these two ratings, power rating and voltage rating, is given in the bulb. So what is the thing we need to study here? We need to study here that from this rating, what all you can calculate. From this rating, you can calculate two more quantities. First, you can calculate the resistance, and second, you can calculate the safe current. Okay, so from here were different formula. Okay, so suppose we are using this formula for power, this one V square by R. You are knowing the value of P, you are knowing the value of V. You can calculate R. Then again, from this formula, P is equal to VI, you are knowing the value of P, you are knowing the value of V, you can calculate I. Clear? Then one more thing you must understand, that if the bulb is rated at 100 watt, okay, or the bulb's rating is 100 watt and its voltage rating is 220 volt. It means if the bulb is exactly connected at this voltage, it will consume this much power. If the bulb is getting a voltage lower than this, then the bulb will consume less power and it will glow dimly. But if the bulb is connected at a voltage higher than this, then that bulb will consume more power and the bulb will glow more brightly. Okay, so if the exact rating is followed, that power, the power rated on the appliance, will be consumed. If the voltage is less, the power consumed will be less. If the voltage is more, the power consumed will be more. Then these all topics are covered. Here the last topic is there, that heating effect of current. According to heating effect of current, whenever the current is flowing in a conductor or a wire, it produces heat. Whenever the current is there, that will produce heat through that wire or conductor. So this heat produced H is directly proportional to length of the conductor, the current flowing in the conductor, and it is directly proportional to the time for which the current is flowing. So here is one equation, H is equal to I square R T. Sorry, here I mentioned one factor here. This, in spite of length, it is resistance. Okay, so I square R T. The more is the current, the more is the heat, the more is the resistance, the more is the heat, the more is the time period, the more will be the heat. This is known as Joule's law of heating. So we are done with this chapter finally.